Good morning, everybody. So I'm finally in the woods. I found a little spot that I'm gonna set up camp today. Probably gonna set up a plough point up against this tree here. Have a fire just over there, maybe. Yeah, and I see there's some bark on a tree over there. I can get some bark to get a fire started. Okay, yeah, let's get set up then. So I'll just give you a bit of a walk around camp. Simple plough point up to this tree. Put my ground sheet down just to get me off the wet leaves. And then I pulled the back out just here on a bungee to that tree. So just to give me a bit more headspace inside. I'll set the hammock up. Set the hammock up over here. I'll just show you where that is in comparison to the camp. There's camp, and there's the hammock. So I've got this another product to try out today. This is called a Kamui chair. It's so lightweight, it's unbelievable. I don't normally bother with a chair. I normally find a log to sit on. But the good thing about these is they all sort of just flick together. Everything just flicks. Flicks together like that. And it's got some good feet on here, so these won't sink. These won't sink into the ground. Let's give it a go. Just poke that through these little holes in the bottom of the fabric, and they're quite reinforced as well, they're quite strong. Push them in and go up to the top, and as you get onto the third one it starts getting a little bit more difficult to get them in, but that's the whole point really, because it gives you that tension. The fourth one is always the hardest. But we got it. I mean, you can just see how light that is. So light. All right, let's give it a quick go. Beautiful morning. Yeah, so I'm somewhere out and sitting having breakfast this morning. I'm just putting in the poles now for the hammock. This is what's going to suspend the bug net away from my face and my body. Trying to thread the bit of elastic through the hole. That's it, gotcha. We're okay this side because we've got a little tree we can tie it to. hammocks up, bug nets up, camps up, chairs up. I think I need to get a fire going. Alright, first things first, let's go and find some wood. Looking for is a bit of dead standing, because that'll still be dry. Okay, still the birch stuff over here. Let's have a look at that piece there. That's it, those bits should do it. Beautiful morning. It's cold, but it is a nice morning. Right, let's get this cup of tea on the go. Oh, blimey, yeah, that's boiling. What a beautiful morning. I've got the sun shining straight into me. I've got the heat of the fire warming me up and a nice cup of tea. You can see the steam coming off the cup of tea. I need to start prepping my dinner, I think. Alright. I'm going to have a good old favourite. Spam and chips. Some baked beans. I've got a couple of mushrooms in there as well. This week I'm going to peel the potatoes, because I was thinking last week I can throw the peels out for the animals. I'm sure the deer will eat those. I enjoyed them chips a lot I cooked last week, so I thought why not. There's a few chips. I suppose I could get them on the go actually. I need to get the fire going again though. Put that in for now. I might need to put a little bit more in, but I don't want to put too much in. Let's get that on the go. I'm going to do these quite thick. That one now, I'm going to take a piece off though because I want to eat a piece now. Lovely. Alright, let's have a sit down and eat this. You just can't beat this, can you, really? Sat in the middle of the woods, sun shining, nice bit of unhealthy food. The fire's still going. No gas and electricity used either. Well, full up now. Right, so I put the pot on using the little Trangia burner to get that going. Just having a look around the floor, and there's you can see all these little bluebell shoots coming through the leaves. In fact, if you brush the leaves away, there you are, look, all these little bluebell shoots coming through. Another 2 or 3 weeks, I expect this area will be full of bluebells. I hope so, because that looks gorgeous. Yeah, so there's two reasons that I put the hammock up today. One, I do like to have a little lay down after I've eaten. But secondly, I've got another product that I want to try out. Yeah, so I've got another product to try out, snugpak. It's actually the hammock underblanket. outer insulation to prevent cold spots, and it also says with antibacterial treatment. So I've never put an underblanket on a hammock before, but well, let's give it a go now. Yeah, well, let's move all this wood out of the way first, because it... Yeah, so, let's have a look. Okay, so looks like we've got two end pieces which I guess you tie them to perhaps to a carabiner or something. I've not got a carabiner on here, but what I'll do is I'll just tie that on like that. If I'm doing this wrong, I will work it out as I go, but at the moment, I'm just trial and error. Right, now then, I see straight away I need to slacken off this end. Give that a little bit more. I think what I do need to do is probably put a couple of carabiners onto this bit of kit, so that in future I've got it there already. But never mind. Let's crack on with this. So now I can pull this up and tie that to there. So, and then you've got these outer pieces, which I guess will help pull it around. Well, I'm going to do it to this because I know that's not right. Just for the benefit of trying it out. It seems quite small compared to the hammock, to be honest. I think the important thing is that you cover your back, and also develop a pocket of air inside it as well, in between it as well. So now let's do the same again to this side. Like I say, I know this isn't right. I just want to try it anyway. Now then, I guess this can be pulled out. So you've got a pull cord and a toggle there. Let's have a look. So I guess I should be able to just pull this. I Unless there's one the other side. You can adjust it on both sides. Okay. So basically what that does, that creates gap in between the hammock and the underblanket to create a pocket of air that warms up and then warms you up as well. Now I'm going to get inside it and see what happens. Now, I can't see what it looks like from the outside. But what I will be able to do is look on the footage. And actually I can already feel a difference to how it was when I got on it earlier on. That has pulled up quite nicely. I'm going to have a little lay down. And as always, you'd never know I've been here. Sunshine shining through the trees. As you can see, I was quite deep into the woods today. Certainly in 2 or 3 weeks we should see the bluebells coming out, I think. I'll keep you informed about them, as you'll see them as I come to the woods. Right, I found a yellow marker post over there. Way out of this section of the woods. Down this ditch. Take a different route back and then take this route. It's marked as a public footpath. Oh, it's quite warm in the sun. The centre of a field. Don't feel right, but that's where it's sending us. I don't know what the crops are. What the crops are in here, I'm sure. Thank you. on the original track again now. So the detour just took me a different way to get to this location. There's clearly been horses going up and down here.